What's going on, guys? Tessit here. So now we're going to take a look at the new KTM crossbow. As I already said in the previous video, I already used this a few times trying to record it and failed. This is the first time I'm actually driving in the snow. This looks beautiful. I always miss, but I never did this before. What time is it? Why is it? Question, are these times daily the same? Because I've been online on this time more often, but I never noticed any snow. But right now it is. Fuck yeah, I mean, I'm playing in the snow for the first time now, I enjoy it. I hope I can use the KTM in the snow as well, but we have to check. But we have to check that out in a bit. And I forgot to drop my mic, so that's why my voice is suddenly better. But this, right now I'm just using the GTR. First time actually using it. And even though it is my favorite car ever, it's just so beautiful. But anyways, let's go to our home and check out this KTM crossbow. Alright, welcome to our home, garage. Is it still snowing? It still is snowing. Well, and as you can see here, I have my newest addition to my garage, the Nissan 370Z. You may be wondering, why not the Nismo? Well, that's a question gonna be answered. I also own the Nismo. But this car is just used for my, for the pure drifting, get as many points as possible. And this one is more used of getting better parts, because the loot parts, whatever is on them, I use those. For example, for the Nismo, I use parts that have multipliers. Wait, I can show you. It's not really a KTM thing, but it's still a little something I want to show. And as you can see, I use this perk, Smooth, in English at least, which well, it doesn't double it, but it adds extra bonus, extra combo. Example, this one gives me 9.4 combo extra. This one, 5 average. And as you can see, this one gives 9 again. With this car, if I use it, it gives a bonus of 97 times instead of the 50 you normally get. So that is quite impressive, if I say myself. And this is also the Nismo I got my record with at the moment of 376k, I think, in the first race. I'm in the top 1300s. But anyways, I want to showcase that and explain it, drifting with both these cars in a later video. Right now, where is my KTM? As you saw in the Ferrari video, I already customized it. Although I forgot to put the special wing on that I bought. But I'm still going to over the customizations. This one is the best you can buy. Well, this one just adds the add-on lights, or the cover at least. But they are also very special to each other. Well, it isn't very new for me anymore, because as I said, I think in the intro, and I think I saw as the Ferrari video, I tried to record 2 times. I did, but I forgot to turn voice on, so it didn't record. Well, it recorded the gameplay, but not my voice. And that's the whole point of a first impressions video, the voice. It doesn't matter what you have on screen, it's a first impressions. Well, oh, I still need to customize the rims, but those look just fine anyway. Of course, the mirrors you can change from black to carbon to paint job. I don't know why. This is matte, I think. I don't know. Of course, you have the amazing skirts, the small ones with no extra add-ons on it. This one, the racing skirt that I own. And the small skirts for sports behavior. Let me just mount the wing that I want. This wing is quite funny. It's small, But still, it gets the job done. If I swear, but it used to be orange as well. And of course, your big giant Wang. Wang means big wing. Which some people really like to have in their vehicle, or at least on their vehicle, but not on this one. I mean, on my drag car, or yeah, drag and drift cars, alright. Race cars as well, but not street cars. I don't ruin my cars like that. Of course, the rear bumpers. This is stock. This is the one I did go for. The big, meaty rear diffuser. Or whatever you want to call it. I think it's a diffuser. And the carbon fiber around the exhausts. That's a nice little detail. I just noticed that. And of course you go from the twins to the twins in the middle. With two different headlights. You can also go for the twin above each other, which I really like as well, but it doesn't have the thing, the big bumper that it says 2018 on the license plate. But it doesn't have the big bumper I like having on it, which is kind of sad. This one, yeah, it isn't much difference either. I mean, you have four exhausts, that is a big difference, but it's still stuck. I mean, nothing else changed besides the exhaust. And of course, the big one that I got. No, wait. Oh, wait. Yeah, it is. It is. I said nothing. And of course, the interior, which I made blue. And for my performance, my car is at the moment 375. It's almost maxed out, but I don't have any better parts at the moment. So I cannot max it out, sadly. But for this race, for these race cars, I don't really look at what I put on them. I mean, this one is quite lucky. But I don't really pay attention to it, if I'm honest. I just race and get it as max as possible and done. For drift cars, I of course do care. Because I want better parts for better scores. And I want to get higher on the leaderboards, because I think it was around 2 weeks ago when I played this game fully about drifting, I was in the top 500 of the world. And that is quite impressive for me. And right now I'm in the top 1300. So I did go a little lower, so I want to come back at the drifting and try to reach at least the top 500 again. But in order to get that, I need better drift scores, I need better parts, and etc, etc, etc. So that will take quite some time to achieve. Anyways, let's take this little beast. I say beast because this thing is lightweight. It has a powerful engine. Does it say? No, it doesn't say. It's light, it has a powerful engine. What could go wrong? All right, let's go to the free mode, or free roam, whatever you want to call it. All right, so here we are outside of the garage where it's... That monster truck has been bugging there for weeks. Literally, every time I'm standing here, I see that monster truck, whether it's that one, or a Fiat 500, or Abarth, whatever you want to call it. I see it bugging out like hell over here. Am I the only one seeing this? It's just really weird. Please let me know in the description below. I mean, it is my connection, because my connection is good. But anyways, now it's still snowing. Let's go. For this thing, as I said, it's pretty much maxed out, so yeah, those are the stats maxed, pretty much. But just look at the acceleration it will get, and compared to its speed as well. And in the snow it looks so freaking beautiful. 330 already. This thing is an absolute beast to use. And I think this is the race I want to do, isn't it? If it is, I completely will... Is it? Let me check. Yeah, alright, let's do this race. It's the one that I wanted to showcase anyway. With this beautiful KTM. I wanted to do some drifting after this recording, but I don't think... Does snow impact the way you drift? I know raining does, and nice doesn't, but that's something I'm curious about. please let me know in the description below. Or in the comments below, sorry.
Come on, you can do it.
And the best part about this race is it's full Japanese and I'm in this KTM. That is still so freaking funny. Oh, GTRs. I'm gonna bring it to this race later as well. It's still weird you see the tracks in front of your car. Or the marks. I mean, that... it shouldn't be there. They should remove that, or at least fix it. And this thing... it's speedy. It has tight grip. Even on snow. Which, I don't know if it impacts the driving. I hope it does. But also hope it doesn't. This car is... this little beast is amazing to drive, seriously. I drive a lot of cars in the crew. I mean, I love using the Ford GT and the Audi R8. Two complete different things. But this one will be one of my new favorites. And as... for the Ford GT and Audi R8, I have Need for Speed Carbon liveries, which I really enjoy. I do own Need for Speed Carbon, so if I want to play, I just play. Maybe, I hope there will be some more liveries for Need for Speed in the crew later on as well. Maybe not only for the crew or Carbon, but maybe Most Wanted as well. I mean, the later Most Wanted games don't really have those unique vehicles anymore. I mean, we know Need for Speed Carbon and Most Wanted had them because of the blacklist. Well, Carbon wasn't really a blacklist, you fought about territories. But still, the principle is the same. Every territory, every group had a unique set of liveries. Now, I would love to see those return in Need for Speed as first, but also to see those liveries on the crew. Maybe that is a solid fence, I didn't know that. And maybe even later, in December, I think it was, they're gonna release the PvP, crew versus crew. And I am excited to play that together with friends, maybe even live stream it with people that are watching, who knows. Just have cars that have the same livery. Maybe different cars, different tunings, of course. I'm not saying the crew has to have the same car. Of course, I can have the KTM, someone else can have the GTR. But it is the best. If everyone in the crew, all four, have the same livery, racing against the other crew with also the same livery. Of course, that won't happen. I know that already. Maybe for the crew I will host, it will. At least I hope it will. But for the others, I cannot promise that. And that is something I am kind of excited for, because we can finally do normal PvP racing. I mean, right now it's just 4 players against 4 AI. And you don't really race to win. I mean, if one person wins, everyone wins. And that's kind of easy, because when my hypercar was just stuck, I just did a race on hard with a friend that had his Regera maxed out. And that is kind of weird. I'm in the stock Saline, no upgrades at all, doing a hard race with a friend that owns a maxed out Regera. He wins, I win. Easy. And that's pretty much how I did all those hypercar races 100%. Well, besides the one you have to race against the other Regera. Of the one that you gave to the street club owner, I think it was. I keep forgetting his name. The wheelchair man, let's just say that. But that's the only race I did win myself. And I really enjoyed that race, but it's not a long cross-country race, which I really like and should be done more. Also, I'm missing some cars in this game. Like some newer Bugattis, the Supersport, of course. I will make a video about that, about what vehicles we should get later on, once I got more ideas. I mean, as idea, I have to add Toyotas, But as we all know, Toyota dropped out of non-racing games. Meaning, in new games like The Crew or Forza Horizon, yeah, Toyota won't appear. At least, I think Forza Horizon, the new one, does have a some Toyotas. But I think those were SUVs. I mean, they don't add Supras, FT1s, and all those exciting Toyotas. Those aren't added in the game, which I am missing. Luckily, in games like Gran Turismo and Forza Motorsport, well, I'm on PS4, so I don't have Forza, they still add them. And that's one thing I like, because Toyota, they are amazing. I love to use the Supras. Which also brings the idea of adding a classic NSX to the game. But that's all future ideas I want to discuss later in detail, which may be a long video, but it will be good, I promise. But anyways, I'm gonna end this video right here. The KTM, soon to be released for everyone. It is an amazing car. It's once tuned, it is insanely fast. As you can see right now, at 300 kilometers an hour. I can use this car for days. So light, so nimble, so powerful. Wish we could have a squadron full of these. Which I may do when December comes, PvP. I may try to go with friends, all KTMs. But I still wonder, how will the PvP mode work? We have to see that in the future. December, that's only 4 or 5 waiting. 4 or 5 months. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this little KTM sneak preview, which later will be available for everyone. Hope you guys enjoyed. Peace out.